Hi, my name is Daniel, and in this video I will show you how to install Custom Queries module. Custom Queries is a module compatible with SugarCRM and SuiteCRM. It will allow you to run your own queries over your CRM database. The way to install it is as usual, using the admin option, module loader. It's available from administration in many of your SugarCRM software. So we are going to proceed directly to installation since I have already downloaded CustomQueries.zip file on my desktop. We go to module loader. Let's get the file from my desktop. While I do this, I can tell you that Custom Queries is intended for experienced administrators. One of its basic functions is to make the same thing you can do with, for example, phpMyAdmin. I have an old version here, I'm going to delete it. Many times, you don't have phpMyAdmin available to run queries or make some works manipulating the database directly. The only caution we took while developing this is not to allow a common user to run this. So we don't have an item from the menu to do this. Well, this is custom queries, and I upload the file. Well, here it is. Now I'm going to install and proceed it. The other caution we took while developing this is that to run it, you must be an administrator of your SugarCRM instance. Anyway, you can place a link to it in your shortcuts. So you must use this at your own risk. Be very careful. Okay, we are installing right now. Taking a little time. All right, now that it's installed, we are going to access it using the following entry point. We can go back or not, it's not necessary, just in case. So, now we are going to change the URL to the entry point necessary to access custom queries. This is entry point equal custom queries. You must be aware of uppercase, lowercase here. Okay. The only element you will see in your screen when you enter the entry point custom queries. It will be a text box at the bottom. In this, you can write your queries. That's it. So, for example, we could use select ID, first name, phone model, primary address, street, primary address, city. Of course, you must know the structure of the tables. Where not deleted. And submit. What I forget? Of course, the name of the table. Select ID, first name, phone, mobile, primary, address, street. From contacts, where deleted. Here it is. This is the query I made. So you can see here you will have a view CSV and download CSV file. Yeah, we are going to download the file and see, but first I'm going to show you that you can also separate queries and give more queries here. For example, a more complex one would be, we are going to delete this and make another one. Select name, see first name, see last name, a phone, office, from accounts, A, alias A, left join accounts contacts. We're going to make this bigger. Account contacts, AC on EAD equal AC account EAD. This is the account contact table is the joining table with foreigners keys. A account ID AC join contacts now C on CAD equal AC contact ID order by A name, A date entered. And here where not A deleted. And deleted. Not C deleted. Yes, this is one query, and now we're going to write another with the so different. Select ID name from opportunities. Where one? We're not deleted. And that's it. So let's submit it. Okay, here goes the first one. You can see the name of the company and the contacts. And then the second query in two different tables. Okay, now, if you use the button View CSV, you're going to get this separated by commas. But you can use this one, download CSV file, and you can download the report 4, for example, and you can edit it with your favorite editor. In my case, I will open it with LibreOffice. When opening it, take care when you're choosing the charset. I'm using UTF-8 in the database, and UTF-8 must be the same in LibreOffice for you to open it. And then you can see I checked all the typical separators. Okay, and here it is. Well, that's it for today. Thank you very much.